believers should make no distinction between the Quran and the universe. In his writing, Nursi examines the universe in the way indicated by the Holy Quran, that he is reading it for its meaning, learning the divine names and attributes and other truths of belief. The purpose of this book is to describe its author and maker and so subscribe all evidence of life in the universe to their creator. Thus, an important element when studying the writings of Nursi, the Risale-i-Nur, is to reflect or contemplate, that is, to read the book of the universe in order to increase one's knowledge of God and to affirm faith in his existence. By using this method, Badiuzama solves many mysteries of the religion in the Risale-i-Nur, such as bodily resurrection, divine destiny, man's will, the riddle of the constant activity of the universe, and the motion of particles.
From the perspective of Risale-i-Nur, Europe can be followed in the field of science and technology, which are the significant means of progress and development. But it cannot be followed in dressing and ways of life. If we will follow them blindly, it will cause the sacrifice of ritual, prestiges, and Islamic tradition. That is why Nursi expressed the differences between the two civilizations through the example, as well as adverse and negative results of the blind imitation.
يقول الأستاذ المسلم: إن الكائنات في غاية البلاغة، كما أن القرآن الكريم في غاية البلاغة، فالكائنات كذلك في غاية البلاغة. قد أنشأها وأنشدها صانعها فصيحة بليغة، كما أن القرآن فصيح وبليغ، فهذا الكون أيضا فصيح وبليغ ويتكلم معه.
Today also I have the same feelings that three Eids have come together. One is this international seminar on the great personality, Allama Nursi. Second, the achievement of the Arabic department to organize an international seminar. And third is meeting my very old and very good friend, Professor Faris Kai. That Allama Nursi did not have family, did not have property, even he does not have a grave. But I feel that he left two great properties. One is Sahib Nur, and the other, his students, his followers, his lovers. He united the Muslim Ummah, and today's seminar is the proof that Turkey and India, Turkey Muslims and Indian Muslims, they are together and they are just sitting to listen only one word, that is Allama Nursi's message.
He has insisted on religious and modern sciences. I just throw the light on Nursi's model for educational reform in present age. The Western style of knowledge and education fused into the Muslim world during the emergence of Western colonization, which resulted in a clash of morals and values in the Muslim world. We can say that Western education, with its absence of harmony between the modern sciences and religious value, has actually been harmful to Muslim world and has created the challenges and dilemma in the Islamic educational system. The process of westernization of education caused to lose the faith-based learning and religious value-based instruction. Integration of religious and modern sciences is another way of resurgence of Islamic culture and civilization. Here also, Nursian view of education shed light on our path to revitalization and empowerment. For integration of both modules, was one of the central factors of his educational reformation movement.